Yo, what is going on, everyone? Guiding Light here, back with another quick Destiny 2 video. In this one, I'm going to be giving you guys a quick overview of the brand new Grandmaster Nightfall, which just came out today. Now, I believe this is a level 2020 activity, and right now there's actually double drops going on. So, this was actually not too difficult if you have a solid team. Just make sure you have the right barriers on, Overload, and the Unstoppable. Now, you're also going to run into a few Solar Shields, and the strike's pretty easy, pretty much up until the boss room, where you just have to be careful for a few wyverns and things that will spawn on the second round. So here's what I was running: just Fatebringer, the brand new sniper rifle, and then a Void heavy machine gun. Now I also have a exotic class item, which is going to give me solar damage on my barricades and also suspend enemies. Now the only thing that I would change up is probably switching supers. It probably would have been better off running Twilight Arsenal. However, running the Blade Fury still had its advantages in the boss room where you could suspend and damage enemies. Also, if you're running Titan or have the option, you may want to run the Shackle Grenades as there is a lot of enemies that will sneak up behind you, especially in the boss room, and these can help quite a bit in case you need to get a res or take down the enemies. You also probably want to throw on the Void Damage Resistance as the Void Damage is actually buffed this week against you. And this resistance will help you to not get taken down by a lot of the Void Blasts. Now, in the beginning room, there's going to be a few invisible enemies. After that, you just have to deal with stunning the champion. After that, you'll go up to the next room, and each room sort of has a safe area before you get in where you can damage a lot of the enemies. Now, the biggest tip I can give you is not to go rushing into the rooms too quickly, as there are the servitors which are going to start to regenerate the enemy's health. Also, if you push too far into the room, it will cause more enemies to spawn. So it's better just to take out the bosses first and then push in after they're all down. Now, throughout this mission, from the beginning to end, there are going to be these vandals that you see. Now, these vandals are honestly your biggest threat in this mission. They have the ability to two or three hit you with their ARC sniper rifles. And they also are very, very hidden, sometimes very far away as well in the back of the rooms, especially towards the middle of the strike. So anytime you see a Vandal, I would suggest you actually focus all of your energy on them. That's actually why part of the reason why I'm running the sniper, as when my other teammates are busy trying to deal damage to the bosses and stunning the champions, I'm able to cover them from the snipers in the back, as they are actually really, really deadly and will take you out pretty quickly before you have a chance to get away. So there's a few points during the mission where you could easily get taken out by all three of you guys could get taken out by it, so just be on the lookout for it and just use the save spots as much as you want so that it doesn't make you waste any revives. Now, those are pretty much all the tips I can give you. Now, in the boss room, I'll show you guys where you need to stand. All you really need to look out for are the wyverns, but if you use your tangles properly and you use the shackle grenades, you should be perfectly fine to take those enemies out pretty quickly. So, hopefully, this guide helps you out. And I'll catch you guys in the next one.
Thank you. quantifying the health of you. Any amount of
thank you.
Peace.